Hello students, in this video lectures we will discuss about the equation of motion. Okay, so see, there are the equation of motion of a body when of uniform acceleration is given by three equation. Okay, one is v is equal to u plus at. Remember, here v is your initial final velocity, u is the initial velocity, a is acceleration, t is the time, and s is the distance covered. Okay, so these are the abbreviation we will use here. Okay, once again I am telling you, see, v is the final velocity, u is the initial velocity, a is acceleration, and t is the time taken, and s is the distance covered. Okay, so there are three equation of motion. Okay, so we have to learn the three equation, and then numericals will also come from this equation. So the first equation is v is equal to u plus at, which means final velocity is equal to initial velocity plus acceleration into time. Okay, then second equation is equal to s is equal to ut plus half at square, distance is equal to ut plus half at square. Okay, and the third equation is v square is equal to u square plus 2as. So first equation, second equation, and third equation, first, second, third. Okay, now one by one we will go through its derivation, how we can derive this equation graphically as well as a normal method. Now let us consider a graph here. Okay, you can see a graph which we have plotted. So a, b, c, d, o. Okay, now first understand that whenever we will take the time should be always taken in the x-axis. Okay, and the other factor you can take in them in the y-axis. Now from this graph, what is the slope of this? Okay, slope of this figure, the slope of this figure is actually the acceleration. We know velocity by time is acceleration. Yes, we know velocity by time is acceleration. So since the slope v by t gives acceleration, what is slope? How we find slope? Slope mean, how to find the slope from the graph? Yes, y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. We have to minus the coordinates. Okay, this is your y2, this is your y1, y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. So you can write slope x is equal to y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. Okay, so this is how we find the slope, or we calculate the slope. So here also we'll do the same thing. See, this is your y2. Okay, y2 mean bd. You see, y2 minus y1 cd. Okay, y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. So this is how we calculate the slope. Actually this is the formula of slope. Now here in this case we'll also apply the same. Okay, bc divided by ac. Now bc, how will you get the bc? You have to minus from bd. Yes, so BD minus CD will give you BC. Yes, divided by AC. AC is the time. So now see, BC is what? BC is the final velocity. Yes, and you can see CD. CD is the initial velocity. You can see it is marked here. CD is the initial velocity. So divided by time. So finally we get V minus U by T. Now AT is equal to V minus U, or V is equal to u plus at. So this is the first equation, okay, of motion. First equation of motion, graphically you can derive this. If it is asked in the question that graphically you have to do, then you can go by this method. Okay, so remember that this is the first equation of motion. Now from that same graph only, okay, we know that the area of the velocity time graph represents the displacement of the body. Okay, now if you find the area of the velocity time graph, then it will give you the displacement. Now S is the displacement or distance traveled is equal to area of region OABD. The OABD is the trapezium, you can see here, okay, in the graph also OABD. So this is a trapezium, right? This is a trapezium. Okay, so if you have to find, if you have to calculate that distance or displacement S, then we have to find the area of that trapezium OABD. Now what is the formula? We'll use half into OA plus BD into OD. See, half into OA, area of this trapezium is equal to half into OA plus BD. Okay, so vertical length you are taking OA plus BD into OD. OD mean time. Okay, so putting this value here, you will get S is equal to half U plus V into T. Yes, if you put the value from the graph, you will get S is equal to half U plus V into T. Now, what is the value of V we have calculated from the first equation? From the first equation, we have seen that V is equal to U plus AT. Now, put that value of V in this equation. Okay, then finally, you will get, if we put the value of V in equation 1, then you will get S is equal to half into U plus AT into T, which will give U S is equal to UT plus half AT square. So finally, you will get S is equal to UT plus half AT square. Now this is the equation, second equation of motion. Okay. Generally the questions come, what is second equation, what is the first equation? Okay. So if it is asked to calculate the distance, okay, then we can use this formula. Third equation, on squaring equation 1, if you square equation 1, what is equation 1 we got? V square is equal to U square plus AT square, yes. So if you square this, V square is equal to U square plus 2UAT plus A square T square, yeah. What is the first equation of motion? Yeah, what is the first equation? This is the second equation we have got. Now on squaring equation 1, equation 1 mean it is the first equation, you see. Equation 1 is first. Now you have to square, V is equal to U square plus 80. Now square it. Okay. So on squaring, what we will get? On squaring, we will get V square is equal to U plus 80 square. Or finally, on solving this, you will get V square is equal to U square plus 2AS. Now, this is known as the third equation of motion. This is the third equation of motion. Okay. So this is the graphical method. Another alternate method which is also easy, okay, we know by definition, we know acceleration is equal to change in velocity by time taken. I think that this will be much more easier for you people to go through the analytical method. So I would suggest you can go by analytical method, whichever is easier for you go by that only. Analytical method, you see, acceleration, we know all acceleration is equal to change in velocity by time taken. So A is equal to V minus U by T. Change in velocity mean final velocity minus initial velocity by time taken. So AT is equal to V minus U, or V is equal to U plus AT. Yeah, finally we got this. This is equation 1. So how easily we can obtain. Next, distance travel is equal to average velocity into time taken. We also know, we have also come across this formula, that the distance travel actually is the average velocity into time taken. Yeah, so what is the formula of average velocity? Average velocity mean initial velocity plus final velocity divided by 2. Okay, so average velocity is equal to initial plus final divided by 2 into time taken. So U plus V, initial velocity is given by U, final velocity is given by V. So S is equal to, and distance is given by S. Okay, just we need to formula, put the symbol. So here U plus V by 2 into time taken. So half U plus V into T. Now putting the value of V here, if you put the value of V in equation 1, then what you will get? S is equal to u plus 80 into t by 2. So finally, you will get S is equal to ut plus half a t square. I think this is much more easier comparatively than the graphical method or whatever you see. If you feel that graphical method is easier, you can go by that. If you think alternate method, but learn both. Okay, at least you should have the idea of both the derivation. Next, third equation, distance travel is average velocity into time again. So S is equal to, we know, u plus v by 2 into t. Okay, so we have t is equal to v minus u by a, right? So putting the value here, substituting the value, putting the value for t, okay, what you will get? S is equal to u plus v by 2 into v minus u by a. Or finally, you will get v square minus u square is equal to 2as, or final velocity square is equal to initial velocity square plus 2as. So this is the third equation of motion. So learn these three equations of motion very nicely. Okay, first, first you have to go through this three equation of motion. Okay, learn these three equation of motion, and after going through it, see in page number 47, okay, you will see that many examples are given. Okay, so go through those examples nicely, understand the application of that formula. When we are using that first equation, when we are using second equation, when we are using third equation, that you need to understand first. So that is the reason, first go through these examples which is given. Okay, once you have gone through the example, then you start doing this section exercise numericals. Okay, so go through it and learn both the methods. Okay, thank you.